takes to the stage way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every wave, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Carolina Panthers. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports.
Fielded in the end zone.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
First down and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Love going to give this one to Jones. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Now third down is looming. A pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there. Working out of the gun. Love. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. And that's a throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Eagles will have great starting field position here as they take over. On first down, Hurts. The 20. Throwing left side, it's complete. Heck of a start, a 30-yard pickup on their first play from scrimmage.
They started this drive with terrific field position, and it's going to get even better after that play. Had great options with where they started, so they decided to press their advantage, and it paid off.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
That play gets them 6 yards and sets them up with a first and goal.
Thank you.
Throwing is Hurts.
And he's got it. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. Well, you've got to like that start on both sides of the football. You force the 3-and-out, and then you score on your first drive.
Well, I know someone who doesn't like that start.
Well, yeah, the other side.
Yeah, they don't like that at all, right? This is not the way it's supposed to be. But what you just described, that's team football. All right, when you get a 3-and-out, you're supposed to take advantage of it on the offensive side of the ball. You said, thank you very much for getting us the rock. Let's put it in the end zone, and they did exactly that.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Love from the gun, eluding the pressure right. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. It's a gain of 5, and it'll be second down. Shotgun, it's Love. He's going to air one out. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. They will throw again here with Jordan Love. Flush to his right. He may try and run for this. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 8 yards that time. Able to take off, and the result is a first down.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, you're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
Have to at least be able to contain him somewhat. There they could not. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 47. To throw now, here's Love. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's 2nd down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. They'll run it with Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
On 3rd down, Love. And this is caught, but I don't think he stayed in bounds. No, he didn't. It's incomplete. The throw took him past the boundary, and it's fourth.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. They start on the ground here at Sanders. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Hurts to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Well, so much for getting separation. No chance there. Locked down tight, forcing the incompletion on that attempt.
From the gun, it's Hurts. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And that will be incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. And no return on this one as that kicks out of bounds, so they'll start just outside of their own 30-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Jones running on first down, but finding it pretty tough going as he'll get forward for only about 3 there before he's taken down.
A 3-yard pickup.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Love this time is going to set up to throw it. And his pass incomplete.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and he's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's going to have to find a groove with a big third down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Operating from the gun, Love. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now 4th down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. 1, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But 2, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
At their own 30-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down. Hurts. Rolling to his right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
From rookie first rounder. He's made a huge impact on this defense, but that tells me that they had a plan for him when they drafted him. Just turn him loose, do what you do best, go get the quarterback.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Hurts sets up to throw it. That'll be caught. Rager with it. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long. Something for deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Oh, yeah. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. They'll look to throw here. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. They go play action with Hurts. He's going to rifle one deep left side. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off down at the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Following the interception, Love. He's going to air one out. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. 92 yards. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 to score as they begin first and 10. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. And he can't find anywhere to go. with it, and he goes down.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top five. Now you add two more to his total.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Out of the gun now on third down. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Play action. Here's Hurts. Sliding out of the pocket. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focused, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
Second and 9 at the 31-yard line.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 19. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. That's going to be caught. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. It looks like a jumbo set with three tight ends here for first and goal. Trying to punch it in with Howard. And a penalty flag down as he gets only about a yard. And let's listen in on the call. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Terrible spot for a holding call as they'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And the Eagles are going to have a first and goal as he's inside the 10 down to the 7-yard line. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. This will be caught at about the 5. Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. The kick by Elliott is good. So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked on since the OTAs and mini camps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two-for-one special to finish things off.
And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
First and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. Taken about 7 yards deep, and he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Off play action, he'll throw to start the drive. Left side here to Sanders. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Second down, here's Hurts, eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. That's caught inside the 20. And they will finally catch him, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A big play there for Philly. 58 yards.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
His pass caught at the 4. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal. They come out 5 wide. 3 of them to the right side. They'll look to throw on third and goal. Strong coverage by Carolina. And now they go to fourth down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. The kick by Elliott is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps the deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Here's Jones. And just not much to be had there. 1 yard out to the 10.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. From the gun, Love. In trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone, loose. Oh, and this is going to wind up a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Oh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on, come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points.
That might be it right there. I think that's the lucky one, y'all.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense.
Yeah,
run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Second and 10 now, third quarter from Charlotte. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at their 48-yard line.
Sanders breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And he is finally going to be brought down, but not before he gets it to the Panthers' 14-yard line. Last play, they didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Now they gain almost 40 yards here. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. He was looking for Miles Sanders out of the backfield, and now it's second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
this is caught. Watkins. And here he'll get it down to the 7. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On 3rd and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And the lead is up to 15 now.
Makes the score Eagles 22, Panthers 7. Jake Elliott to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
At their own 16-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. To throw again, Love. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Jones. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. 11 yards there. First down.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Love. They go play action now. Going up top. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Jordan Love, ready on first down here. Flush to his right. And now he's going to use his legs. It'll be 1st and goal when we come back. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Love from the gun. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead.
The tight end position has always been dangerous, especially in the red zone, short field. But now even more so because these tight ends aren't necessarily the tight ends of old. They're the rocked up wide receivers who have a little bit more speed, way harder to cover than before.
They're going to run for it with Jones, but he will not get into the end zone. And that one hurts as it will remain a 2-score game here in the 4th.
Well, partner, since this new 2-point rule came into play, offense has spent a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
And the Eagles dodge a bullet. They cover it up. Well, 4th quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
At the 43-yard line.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Throwing left side, it's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Guys, you can do better.
Way to move it.
First and 10, it's Hurts. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run with Sanders. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders with touchdown number 3 in the game and 6 on the year. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. He's got the hat trick, 3 touchdowns now.
Did you throw yours? Did you throw yours out
there? I didn't have mine. You've got yours. You've got one of those Abe Lincoln hats.
Yeah, and that stovepipe is going right out there for him. A nose for the end zone. Third time today. I think he deserves a tip of the cap.
And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. And, of course, on the two-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
Felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? An open receiver, ball's put on him, 2 points for them.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This one certainly has not gone according to script. You would have thought on paper that this offense would have its way here, but they certainly have not, and they trail big. After this, it figures to be a quiet trip home. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. First down, going to the air with Love. Sisters running back Aaron Jones, and he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
It's a gain of 7, brings up 2nd and 3 at the 45-yard line.
Love now on 2nd down. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
The Panthers on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. To the air again, Love. He's gonna look deep for more. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, this defensive pressure's been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
1st and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll find a little space. He gets us up near the 10. A.J. Boye up to make the tackle. Good gain there on first down. It keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They're in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
But first down, Hurts. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. Whistles now in a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the two-minute warning. And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. From the gun, it's Hurts. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was hoping to get that to John Hightower. And it'll bring up third down.
Now, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away. Turned into a nice play.
The Eagles on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 14. Goddard, his tight end over the middle. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They go back to the ground with Sanders. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking. 32-yard line.
They'll go again with Sanders. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out, didn't give him a cutback lane. On each play, you have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse. They played that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of bounds. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 17 yards and a first down for Philly.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller, since that the screen pass was available, whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
First down carry here for Johnson. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Big Derrick Brown making the stop.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Johnson, and not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
And it's 3rd down.
Today's final
a road
score,
win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together.